Hello. Welcome to another in the series, Let the People Speak. Tonight, Let the People Speak is honored to present to you information on Wing Chun and on self-defense and a demonstration. The demonstration and the information on Wing Chun comes from the American Wing Chun Academy here in Austin that was founded by Master Richard Guerra. And the discussion will be with a student and instructor of the American Wing Chun Academy in Austin, Carolyn Ritter. Thank you for coming to the show, Carolyn.
Thanks for having me, Trella.
First of all, tell us a little bit about what Wing Chun is.
Wing Chun is a form of Kung Fu. There are many forms of Kung Fu. This form happened to be founded and developed by a woman, a Buddhist Shaolin nun named U Mui, in the late 1600s, early 1700s. And U Mui escaped the destruction of the Shaolin temple that happened in the late 1600s in China. The temple was burned to the ground at one point. And she took her knowledge and teachings off to another province and developed a fighting technique that uses science and strategy rather than strength, because she was a very small woman. And she realized at some point in her life that she couldn't defeat a male attacker unless you used agility, leverage, science, and strategy.
Well, I've heard that the really interesting thing, or there are many interesting things about Wing Chun, is that, like what you said, people with not a lot of body strength or small of stature, and that's a lot of women, that it's a very good self-defense technique for small people.
Yes, that's specifically why it was developed. There's an interesting story around this. U Mui, the founder of Wing Chun, heard of this young woman named Wing Chun, meaning beautiful springtime. And she was in love and wanted to marry this younger man than she. And this rogue from another province had chosen her as his wife, and she didn't want to marry this man. He was very brutal. And so U Mui suggested to Wing Chun to write him a letter and say, put it off for a year. And U Mui took Wing Chun up into her province and trained her in the art of Wing Chun, and the fighting art that she developed off of watching a fox and a crane fight in the woods. One afternoon, she got the idea. Well, this is how you use your arms and your legs, watching two animals fight. And anyway, the story goes on that Wing Chun developed very rapidly and within a year could defeat her male attackers, and sent a letter off to this rogue in the next province and challenged him to a fight. And of course, he came lumbering and barreling in, and she defeated him and won her heart's desire. He didn't marry her. He wimped off, and she got to marry the other.
How long have you studied, Carolyn?
I've studied Wing Chun for 3.5 years under Grandmaster Sifu, which means teacher, Richard Guerra.
And was it hard for you to get into it? Is it a very strenuous training?
The concept and idea was not hard for me to get into. And I was used to Tai Chi because I've also studied a little Tai Chi. The training is very strenuous, and my body was not used to these specific forms. So yes, it was awkward and clumsy at first. However, I rapidly, that's what I like about Wing Chun, I rapidly got over that, and it felt normal. It felt like I could sink into it at a very early stage. Like within the first year, I felt the form, whereas like it takes much longer with some other hard styles and soft styles to feel comfortable with it.
Well, I'm going to ask a two-part question here, and that is, why did you start getting involved in studying the martial arts, specifically Wing Chun? And then, why is it important for women?
I got involved in the martial arts much longer than 3 years ago, much farther back, because I myself have been attacked. And I realized that to meet the challenge of such a violent society towards women, that we had to learn to defend ourselves and not allow those kind of attacks on our physical beings, women and children specifically, and older people. And my political consciousness was raised from my own experience of being attacked and of seeing the communities of women all over this country. I mean, rape is the, you know, most violent crime on the rise. You know, domestic violence is on the rise. It's incredible. Plus, I wanted to be able to secure the political work that I do. I've done work against the Klan. I've done women's issues work. And oftentimes, these political organizations and meetings or demonstrations are attacked by reactionary forces. And I wanted to be able to provide security for the political work we do.
Now, you were telling me at one point that there's a difference between the art and the martial art of Wing Chun and street techniques. You don't have to be an accomplished Wing Chun martial artist to also defend yourself.
That's correct. Let me explain this a little bit. Classical martial arts is the studying of hard style, karate, you know, or soft style, kung fu. You get into the more historical, classical aspect of martial arts. Now, self-defense techniques have been developed from dirty street fighting. Mm-hmm. Now, martial arts helps you enhance and strengthen your self-defense techniques and raise your awareness to your environment. And also, any martial artist will tell you that peace first, fight mm-hmm. last.
I wanted to ask you about that because I know you and I know some of the people who work through the American Wing Chun Academy, and my impression is that you're very spiritual and gentle people for being involved in the martial arts. And I've seen a demonstration, and you'll be showing us soon both Wing Chun as a martial art, and then you will show us some techniques about street fighting, right? Mm-hmm. But tell me just a little bit about this philosophy, because you go gently in the world and then you take them out if they come and mess with you, right?
That's right. that's boiling it down to brass tacks. My philosophy is, because I've studied a lot of Chinese as well as Japanese philosophy, excuse me, is that I avoid a confrontation and a fight at all costs. However, if I am grabbed or touched, or somebody accosts me, that's it. It should not go any further than there. That the situation is taken immediately into control. The most damage is done in the least amount of time to escape your attacker. I would never stand around for a fight. I would do what I have to do and leave the scene immediately. I'm not into fighting. I've never been into fighting, quite frankly. I would prefer to use my martial arts just as a soft standing meditation. However, we don't live in a world where there, you know, it allows you just that. We have to protect our, you know, our dignity. We have to protect our bodies, ourselves.
And the interesting thing that I learned from my little exposure to it is that knowing self-defense enables one to be more peaceful.
That's correct.
Because you know that you don't have to be attacked. You can defend yourself.
That's correct. And if I see a confrontation coming at me, I will not go to that confrontation. I will leave. The thing about martial arts is that your what the Chinese call your yi, which is your awareness, your perimeter is expanded so that your feelers go out more and more and more, so that you are more consciously, you can feel somebody walking up behind you and, you know, they're going to attack you and you take off. You don't meet it. You avoid it at all costs. And you know, for me, I honor and cherish the martial arts for giving me the ability to be cool-headed, quote unquote, in situations like that.
And just before we do the demonstration, which we'll give us even more information and helpful hints for women in defending ourselves against violence against women. Just quickly tell us about the school here in Austin, and that people later at the end of the show will be able to give you information about how to get in touch with people at the American Wing Chun Academy in Austin. But tell me a little bit about the school itself so that people will know if they want to get more information and come and start studying with you all.
Mm-hmm. The American Wing Chun Academy is located on South First Street. And we are a small school. We're not highly funded. However, I think that training under the teacher that I've been training under, who is Sifu Guerra, has benefited me and can benefit many, many women in the community, because he does bring to his teachings the understanding that you don't have to use muscle. You use strategy. He's older. I'm older. I can't move like I used to. I can't throw real high kicks like I used to. And our school stresses low kicks. Wing Chun stresses low kicks. And Sifu Guerra, he's wonderful like this. He says, why waste your energy and your time? Go for the low kick. Go for the simplicity, you know. Our school is, we have about 35 students now. We're always looking for new students. Sifu Guerra is working on a movie right now called The Bamboo Cross. He's written a script and is hopefully going to get some backing for it. We hope to see that this is a success. I just want to say I think he's one of the best martial arts teachers anybody could have, and I'm very glad to have studied under him.
Are you going to be teaching a class for women, both Wing Chun and self-defense?
I certainly hope so. I've been trying to get students. I have some personal students right now that I teach individually, and I'm going to try and develop a self-defense class for the fall in September that does not teach classical Wing Chun, that teaches self-defense techniques and then a brief introduction into classical Wing Chun in hopes to recruit some students.
Well, at the end of the program, we'll let everybody know about how to get in touch with you and with the school, so that this will encourage more women to learn self-defense and learn Wing Chun also. We're now going to have a demonstration and see what this is all about.
Thanks, Trella.
Thanks for coming.
was student and instructor from the American.
Like, as if you're talking, say, to somebody in the back of the room.
Good evening. Tonight, another student from the American Wing Chun Academy and I are going to perform some very simple self-defense techniques that I encourage everybody to watch and get a partner in practice. These techniques are for very standard attacks. Lee Guerrero is a kung fu buddy of mine from the American Wing Chun Academy, and we do these self-defense techniques in class often. And after we show you a couple, I'm going to ask somebody from the audience, victimos, to come in and practice on me. The first one will be a front throat grab. Grab here, knee to the groin, twice. Kick here to the knee, down to the kidneys. Now this self-defense technique is very important because what happens usually, grab me, somebody grabs, immediately you go like this, let me go, you go to the source. That's not going to help you. You've got these, we forget about them. Relax and remember, don't do this, don't try and struggle out of it, you'll never win. Grab, knee to the door, twice. Usually they'll go down just after that. The second one is an attack. Usually people, when they hit you, swing wide, like this. It's a very simple technique to stop the fist from coming in and joint locking to the knee, grabbing the upper body and pulling it into you. Grab here, grab onto it, jam the knee, pull the body to you, go down on the back, kidneys, got his hand here, once again, see, grab onto him, jam the knee there, pull the body in, squeeze that elbow, ugh. Elbows are very important, they're always there, once again, ugh. Come across the face with the elbow, down, and into the back. Lower back always. Okay. This next one is the same thing. Panic sets in when you're down. You're down, you're trapped. You feel like there's nothing you can do. You've got these, you've got these. Use them. This one is for a throat hold. Grab the person, lift and raise. To the heart. It's very important for women to use their pelvic region because lifting up is one of our strengths. When you're down, somebody's got you on the ground, your hands are trapped, you can't get your feet up here, lift the pelvic. Look at that. Natural as can be. Ah! Now we're going to do one very simple. Somebody grabs you from behind. This is a really good one because it uses leverage. You drop down, you're here. All you do is grab a hold of his ankles or his pants. Stand up to the groin. All you have to do is grab those pant legs. If you drop down, you've got the leverage. He's gonna go down with you. You stand up. To the groin. Now, the thing about self-defense techniques is it's hard to figure out a strategy when you're freaked out, when you're scared. Fear takes over. Use a second, just 1 second, and figure out what you're gonna do. Don't let the panic set in. We thank you very much for spending this evening with us.